the very best in professional wrestling, worldwide wrestling. Have we got an exciting match for you right now? Brian Adidas, Pistol Pez Wiley. There they are, Brian Adidas. He's going to be in that ring first. They're against Gary Rowell and Doug Vines. Gary Rowell's in that ring right now. This is going to be some match. Four young, aggressive, exciting wrestlers. And have we got a program for you? Coming up in the program, you'll see Tully Blanchard, Wahoo McDaniels, Ricky Steamboat. We have an interview from him. Some of Ric Flair. Good arm drag. Brian Adidas now holds him down. Plus, Angelo Mosca Jr., the Renegade, and Mark Youngblood. The Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Vant, Rufus R. Freight Train Jones, Kamala, Adrian Street, Paul Jones. What a tackle that was. Watch this, pistol pass, picks him up, presses him, up, he has him, hard, slammed down on that mat. Right. Oh, what a forearm. Brian Adidas. Gary Rowland says he's down on that mat. Pez catches him with another one. Pez struts over. I know. Doug Vance comes in. Slowly but surely. Good arm drag. Nice drop kick by Pez. Another drop kick. Has him going. Vance doesn't know where to go, but outside that ring. Gets in that corner. Pez picks him up. Yes. Drops him. On that back. Tags now. Brian Adidas. Adidas now catches him. Form now. Into the ropes. Good tackle by Adidas. Adidas headlock, takes him over, holds him down. Bends over. Referee Tommy Young makes for the count. Adidas still has the headlock. Comes up. Standing wrist lock. Tags. Gary Rowell. Rowell catches him right in the midsection. Good forearm. Forearm right back by Adidas. Adidas catching the elbow in the back of the neck. Picks him up. Headlock. Takes him over. Tags. Pistol Pez. Pez has him. Has Royal. Headlock. Has it in tight. Remember, coming up in the program, too, we're going to have a six-man tag team match. What a match that's going to be, too. All right, Gary Royal. Catches him. Another one. Pez comes right back, the fist to the forehead, headbutt! Tags, Adidas, elbow to the back of the neck, remember the headbutt, the elbow in the back of the neck, the Sydney Nut whips him across, catches him, a drop kick right in the face. Right now, Brian Adidas has him. Takes that tag to Pistol Pez Wiley. Form now. Headlock by Gary Rowell. Rowell into the ropes though. Good tackle on Pez. Pez ducks down. Jumps over. Jumps over again. Oh! Flying headbutt! Knocks Rowell down. Goes for the pin. And have we got a winner? And these fans are excited. Pistol Pez Wiley and Brian. And boy, are they exciting enough. Fans love it, too. Watch this now. Adidas comes up, catches him right in the face. And your winners, Pistol Pez Wiley and Brian Adidas. And with me right now...
Whip, I believe is how it's pronounced.
The NWA television champion, Tully Blanchard, and his $10,000.
And his championship belt. You know, a couple weeks ago, everybody was so proud, especially you, David Crockett. Ric Flair came out here and actually insulted me. But I tell you what, he who laughs last, laughs best. Now, the world's heavyweight champion, the number one professional wrestler in the world today, and all you people around the world, you think he's the greatest thing since sliced bread. But now, Ric Flair, you listen to me. What kind of man are you? Although you are a great, great wrestler, and you are, you're the number one wrestler, you hold the belt that proves it. But what kind of man are you? What kind of intestinal fortitude? What are you made of to allow somebody to come on national television and humiliate you and tear your clothes off? and spit in your face, slap you like a dog. But I tell you what, right, I don't want to talk about
right.
it anymore.
Let's show the people
I want
exactly
to show
what
everybody. I want to show everybody.
All right. Let's see it right now.
Now, I've done everything there is to do in sports. I've been a pro football player. I've been all pro. I've wrestled. I have as good a win record as anybody in wrestling today, maybe better than anybody. But yet, no contracts for the world's belt ever come my way because I'm the good old Indian. Well, you know, I get a little tired of it sometimes.
I think maybe we can ask this man right here, fans. Here he is,
you know, Bob,
the world champ, Ric Flair.
This goes back to what we said earlier. The World Heavyweight Championship is what it's all about in professional wrestling. But, you know, that's a little bit of a personal deal between Wahoo and I. You know, if you got a chip on your shoulder, Chief, you don't got to tell Bob Caudle about it. Tell me about it.
Bob Caudle.
Oh, wait, Kelly Blanchard.
You know, hey, I ain't got nothing time to him, but I tell you what, Flair, after last
I'm
week,
to
I tell you what, where is your tie? Where is the great-dressed Ric Flair? How come you're not out here looking so fine like you're supposed to look like in Texas?
Come
like
here,
you
Wally.
All this stuff. You ain't got no time Blanchard. To talk to him.
Talk to me, a true champion, a champion to a champion.
Blanchard,
where are your
you
fine?
Something.
Look at
if you're
this.
Comparing yourself to me, brother, you better start on the bottom of my shoes.
All right, fans, Tully Blanchard to attack Ric Flair, and Wahoo's just tearing the clothes right off of him.
Well, you know, Carl, I can't very well step in there because I can't blame the man. At least Tully Blanchard is man enough to put up his title, and how could I get mad at somebody like that?
And there goes Tully Blanchard and Ric Flair right out after him, Wahoo.
That's right. You know, Bob, it makes me sick sometimes when I think that they always say, bring the Indian along, let him drive the car, give him a couple of beers, keep him happy. Then we'll never have to wrestle him, right?
Hey, Ric Flair right here.
What's the deal with you, huh? Well, I can't jump on the man when the man, at least he puts his title up and tries to defend it and gives me a chance. Harley Race puts the title up against me. You know, I've heard you telling people, you babysat me, you've been taking care of me, you want a title shot, you got it, because I never left your side one time, brother. Put it on the line.
Well, let me tell you something. Every time we rode together and the people come up and say, yay, Ric Flair, you're the world champion. Oh, hi, Wahoo. You know how that's stuck in my craw? I'm
going
to tell you something.
Sacrificing. Now you're the big deal, and I'm just a little old poor Indian. You put the title up before.
Put your name on the dotted line.
You show me a contract in 2 weeks.
Show me a contract.
Put your name on the line.
Show me a contract I can write.
All right, Wahoo, he said, and you heard Ric Flair, fans. In 2 weeks, he'll be back.
All right, Tully Blanchard. At least Wahoo McDaniels has respect for you after you tore the clothes off.
Wahoo McDaniels got respect for me because of what goes on inside the squared circle. Because he can't take my $10,000 or win the belt in 20 minutes. But they are battles. I show the scars. But I tell you what, you know, everybody wants the World's Heavyweight Championship belt that Ric Flair has. Everybody wants to be number one man. You know, Wahoo McDaniels wants to come cry about it. I deserve it. I deserve this. I'm going about it a little bit different. I'm going to humiliate Ric Flair into getting in the ring with me. I'm going to spit on him, and I'm going to slap him, and I'm going to tear his clothes off every time I see him until he gets in the ring, because I'm betting my $10,000, David Crockett, my $10,000 that all you hard-earned people out there sent to me, that Ric Flair will lose his World's Heavyweight Championship belt to me. But now you got somebody, Ricky Steamboat, the closet of the Queen City, Ricky Steamboat, sitting in his gym with his summer exercises with some girl doing bench presses. Now, what kind of man is he? He's in the same old Ric Flair. I tear Flair's clothes off, and he doesn't do nothing about it. Steamboat, I kick him right in the middle of the ring and leave him laying. Now, what kind of U.S. heavyweight champion is that? Steamboat, come out of your gym and do something about it. Somebody please come and shut me up. Please
right,
come.
We'll do and that take right now. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back
don't
with more right after this.
Don't cut.
Where do you want to eat?
He is everywhere. This
This is in Japan when he's
defending the World Heavyweight Championship against Kerry Von Erich. Ric Flair slows to get in that ring. There you see it. The Japanese love wrestling. Wrestling is one of their national sports. Ric Flair, what a World Heavyweight Champion he is. And he is the world champion. All right, now, Kerry Von Erich, he's in that ring now. He comes in. This is after a previous match when Kerry Von Erich beat Ric Flair. Ric Flair, though, is in there to win that championship back everywhere. There you see him right now. They're in that ring waiting for that match. And another man that's waiting for a match, Chief Wahoo McDaniels.
David, that's all fine and good that the man is over there to, and he won the belt back from Kerry Von Erich, who's a kid who's been wrestling maybe 4 or 5 years. Now here's a man that's been wrestling about 20 years. I've been waiting for a title shot. I've been a friend of Flair's. I've been an enemy of Flair's. But you know, the man, since I took 2.5 months off to help him train for this match with Harley Race when he won the belt back. And I'm not saying that I was the deciding factor in him winning the belt back, but I'm just saying since he's gotten the belt back, he's defended it against Steamboat. He's defended it all over. Well, Flair should pick up some magazines, and maybe he has. That's what the problem is, and sees that I'm rated in the top 3 wrestling magazines all through the United States. I'm a big card in Japan. But yet Ric Flair has never, ever put that title up against me. Well, he seems to think that Steamboat is the number one challenger, but I agree with him at all.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you know, Wahoo was talking about Ricky Steamboat. We have an interview from Ricky Steamboat. Let's see that right now.
You know, ladies and gentlemen, I came out of retirement. I've got a good, successful business. Everything's fine. I've been around the world. I've held every title that there is to be held, except for one. And that was my reason for coming out of retirement. The NWA World's Heavyweight Championship, which is now held by Ric Flair. And you got to take things one thing at a time, step by step. You just can't jump into everything. I had to become a number one contender. I had to win the U.S. belt. Now, Wahoo McDaniels, he wants to wrestle Flair. He feels that he is the number one contender. Well, Wahoo, it seems as though that you're going to have a match with this belt on the line to determine if you are or if I am the contender, and you will get your matches.
All right, there you saw Wahoo. He's wanting to give you a match.
Well, you know, he's in a situation like me, and I can't blame him. He's held every major belt in the world today except the NWA belt. Now, I did hold the NWA belt one time for one day, which I might have a little jump on him. But Steamboat seems to think every time Flair comes here, because he's the U.S. Heavyweight Champion, he automatically is the one that's supposed to wrestle Ric Flair. Well, that's not the way it works, Steamboat. Now, you've been sitting over in a gym, you work out, you wrestle maybe 8-9 times a month, you pick your own times. I'm out traveling all over. Recently just beat Harley Race 9 times, world champion 3 times. So I'm going to tell you one thing, Steamboat. You've given me the match. And now we're going to go out and we're going to find out just who the number one man is to wrestle Ric Flair when he comes to this area. Steamboat, it's like I said, I'll say it again. I'm going to beat you any way I can. And you can take it for what I'm saying or for what it's worth. I will beat you any way I can, and you've never been in the ring with a man like me. And when I'm determined, like I said, any way, Steamboat, I'm going to be the number one man.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you heard from Chief Wahoo McDaniels. Now let's show you Ric Flair in action, winning the World's Heavyweight Championship back. And what a champion Ric Flair is. The World Heavyweight Champion. There you see it right now. Ric switches him, pulls him back. He's got him. And that's it. And Ric Flair, the World Heavyweight Champion once again. What a champion, Ric Flair.
Let's take time out for these commercial messages about the worldwide wrestling events coming up in your area.
You're going to want to be at the Greensboro Coliseum Saturday, July 7th, because on that card you're going to see the Giant Kamala, Assassin 1 and 2, go up against the Midnight Express. Then end up a television title, Ricky Steamboat takes on Tully Blanchard. Then Paul Jones has to get in the ring with the exotic Adrian Street and Miss Linda for 5 minutes. That's not enough for the world's heavyweight title. The champion, Ric Flair, is up against Chief Wahoo McDaniels. Let's hear from Ric Flair right now.
They say that Wahoo McDaniels is too tough, too much man. He's got too much experience. And they say, most of all, that he's the man that made Ric Flair what he is today. Well, Wahoo, we're going to find out. I'm coming home to the Mid-Atlantic area. You got a world championship match. You got me, brother. And when you get in that ring, you forget all the nice things you taught me and be prepared for the wrestling match. Like, woo!
Exciting wrestling comes to Harrisonburg, the Harrisonburg High School Gym, Thursday, July 12th. Remember, that's Harrisonburg, Thursday, July 12th. Then Lynchburg Armory is the place to be Friday, July 13th. On that card, you'll see Nikita Koloff. Plus, a match for the world's tag team title. Don Canole and Ivan Koloff go up against Mark Youngblood and the Renegade. With me right now, the world tag team champions.
Exactly right. Everywhere we go, we put up these titles because we're the greatest champions of all. Now, Renegade and Youngblood. It's going to be the time of your life. It's going to be the battle of your life right there in the Lynchburg Coliseum, because Koloff and I have made a pact, and we want to do one thing and one thing only. Not only do we want to put you, Renegade, back in the hospital, but we want to put you, Mark Youngblood, both of you in the hospital at once, and in Lynchburg is a great place to do it. Don't you think so, comrade?
This is right, Pride. We are the gold medal winners, the world tag team champions. Nikita has already won gold medal also for his victory in ring. I am very proud of Nikita, little nephew. He tried to look like, just like his uncle, Ivan. Shaved head, same haircut. He goes in ring. He is very strong man. He's competitive in the Olympic. Although boycotted, he is going to come into America here and prove to all the American people why the Russian athlete is number one. Along with Pride, he's going to get into the ring in Lynchburg and have match. This Renegade painted face. Break all the rules. But it's just started between us. We are not afraid of them. We are going to put them in the hospital.
The Red... Oscar Jr. is in there against Paul Kelly, and he's a good wrestler, too. Do you see right there? Nice takedown, but they're both up. Kelly backs up. Headlock now. Tomas goes behind. Good. Takes him by the leg. Comes up. Headlock. All right, the headlock to wear Kelly down. He realizes Kelly, he is pumped up. He is ready to go. Kelly tilts him. Count of one. Still holds on that headlock. Control. Let's see if this young man, Angelo Mosca Jr., has the control in this match. That's what you need. Jumps over. Good drop kick on Kelly. Mosca headlock, takes him over again, holds him down, wear him down, cut the blood supply off, the win. Make him fight for everything he gets. Headlock now, Kelly. And both men come up into the ropes now. They come across. Duck under. Side body block goes down for the pin. Oh, almost. Count of two. Headlock again. Mosca. Control. This young man has got it. You know his situation with the Outlaw. The Outlaw, Mid-Atlantic heavyweight champion. All right, Kelly catches him with a forearm in the midsection. Another one. Mosca after him. And I know this young man will fight the Outlaw with everything he's got to win that Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Championship back. Referee Tommy Young counts again. Paul pulls that shoulder up. Headlock. Angelo Mosca Jr. still wearing Kelly down. Kelly, a strong, aggressive wrestler. Mosca. He's matured into a smooth, cautious, steady wrestler. And then ropes. Knee in the midsection. Snapmare. Takes Mosca to Kelly. Elbow across the chest. Goes for that pin. Kelly needs to grab that leg. Right now, he has the arm bar on Mosca. Kelly. Mosca throws Kelly in the ropes. Good tackle. Knocks both of them in now. Kelly's first one up. Right now, Mosca quickly grabs him around the waist. Kelly was going to try a suplex. I've seen this young man try it. He does well. Uh-huh. Takes him over. Kelly takes Mosca over. All right, Mosca now has that arm bar. And they're in the ropes. Kelly catches him with a knee in the midsection. Whips him across. Try to catch him with that arm. Good tackle. Runs right into him, tackles him. Mosca picks him up. Hard slam on that mat. That's Kelly get up again. Slams him, yes. Once more, hard down on that mat. Goes up. And this man has got this move patented. Comes off. Flying side body block. Goes down for the pin. And he's got it. Angelo Mosca Jr. is your winner over Paul Kelly. What a beautiful win for this young man. One of the young lions. Angelo Mosca Jr. Watch, he ducks under, comes across, catches Paul Kelly, side body block, and your winner, Angelo Mosca Jr. All right, ladies and gentlemen, Mark Youngblood and the Renegade.
Well, let me tell you something, David. You know, a lot of things have been happening here in the Mid-Atlantic area ever since I've been here. It's been almost 9 months now. And I've started from the bottom, and I've seen what's going on. And I've worked from scratch and built up to a mold. But no, Don Canoodle, Ivan Call, have been going around saying how they put Jay in the hospital. That's right, you did put Jay in the hospital. But I tell you what, it's just like a little magic. Somebody's here to take his place, and he's here in Jay's soul. So beware, Ivan and Don, because the Renegade is here. Beware.
You know, David, there's been a lot of controversy about who is the Renegade. Well, Don Canoodle, Ivan Koloff, this is a Renegade, right here, the man that you supposedly put in the hospital. That's right, you might have, brother, but I had to sit on my desert, brother, down in New Mexico, and had to regroup. Remember, Canoodle, New Koloff, the Renegade, and Mark Youngblood, the world champions one day.
We'll be back with more right after this.
It's a film here on everybody watching on nationwide TV and roll the film on everybody watching.
All right, let's see that. There it is right there. Paul Jones banging away on you with that cane.
That's right. And Dusty Rhodes came in the rain to my rescue. Thank God if he did. If he didn't, they'd beat me to death in that rain there. Dusty Rhodes just body slammed Paul Jones and pulled his jacket off. Right here, Dusty Rhodes, right now going for the figure four. Watch right here. Going for the figure four. Paul Jones got a hurt leg. He got him out. Right here, look at David. See there? Got him out. Now, Dusty, using that cane, beating with his own cane there. Got him down. Now, here comes Kamala.
That's right. Kamala's in there. And he squashes.
That's right. For no reason at all, he had no bit in a fair out match at all.
Now, watch this, Rufus. He comes off that top rope some 400 pounds on Dusty Rhodes.
That's what hurt Dusty right there. Let me tell you something, brother and sister. Because one thing for sure, they're going to be a stop to it. Because I got a man, my friend, that stand behind me all the way from New York City, my soul, brother. Jimmy Valley. Come on, brother. We're going to do it to him and do it together, brother.
Luke Glenn, you're my brother. Stevie Cracker, you're my brother. Dusty Rhodes, you're my brother. And every person out there on TV land, you're my brother. That's the Boogeyman's brothers. But Paul Jones, you're not my brother. You're not my father. You're not my mother. You're not my cousin. You're not my uncle. He is not related to the Boogeyman at all. You know something. He's got a registry, you see. And I was number one on the list. Rufus R. Jones was on the list. Dusty Rhodes is on the list. Well, they heard Dusty Rhodes. He's got a cracked rib. Well, Mr. Kamala, he's in his army, you understand? And the assassin's in his army. Well, we got a list of our own. And Paul Jones, you are number one on our list. Kamala.
And what I did, that's what you see I was looking at. Kamala. I was looking at this man, and I, with your first look at him, you're speechless. This man is big. There you see Paul Jones. on Friday. Kamala's trainer. Paul Jones trying to instruct Kamala to get in that ring. Kamala. Paul trying to push him in that ring with that cane. Kamala pacing back and forth just like an animal. Just like a savage animal. Kamala. Look at him. He's getting his music. Friday trying to get him in. Trying to get him in that ring. Fortinelli. This young man he's got a lot of guts to go up against. There you see Kamala. Oh. What a beast. Paul Jones standing there with that smirk on his face of satisfaction. Friday trying to take Kamala's things off, get him ready for the match. Kamala, look at him. He just looks like a wild animal. Pacing back and forth. Friday trying to hold him back. Look at him. Friday's having a problem controlling him. He wants to get some of his things off. Kamala is so big and strong. He's pacing. Right now. They ring that bell. Jones is trying to hold Kamala back. Can anybody hold back Kamala? You saw what Kamala did to Dusty Rhodes. You heard what Rufus R. Freight Train Jones and Jimmy Vance said. Paul Jones needs a man like Kamala to keep Dusty Rhodes, Jimmy Vance, and Rufus R. Freight Train Jones away from Paul Jones and the assassin. Paul Jones has his registry. Oh, look at Paul. Look at that smirk. Petting Kamala just like he pet an animal. I said, get him. And then Kamala. Chops him. Chops Cordinelli to the head, the shoulders. Chops him down on that mat. Pounding away, not giving Cordinelli a chance. The animal is, look at him. The animal is. Cordinelli trying to hold on. Kamala picks him up. Hard down on that mat. Kamala backs up again. Down on the cross. 400 plus pounds on Cordinelli. Knocks the wind out of him. He's down on that mat and out. You're away, but Kamala. Kamala's going up. He's going to the bottom rope again. Jones is trying to hold him back. Friday's over there. Kamala. He has a pace. He smelled the victory. He wants more. He wants Cordinelli. Jones trying to hold him back. Kamala's got Jones's cane, bites at it. Friday finally holds him down. Look at Kamala now pacing back and forth. They get him down. He's down on that floor. Cameraman back. He looked like he was going after the cameraman for a second there. To get him out. They get him out of that ring. And they're out. All right, ladies and gentlemen. You saw it. Let's see again. Watch what he does with Cordinelli. Picks him up and throws him clear across the ring. Your winner, Kamala the Beast, with his manager, Paul Jones. We'll be back with more.
Move Up weeknights at 7:30 with...
Everybody's been asking me the reason why there is so much controversy between myself and Paul Jones. And believe me, there is a lot of controversy. I believe you've got a film that I would like to be shown, because every time I have to explain what happened and the reason I feel so angry, it makes me extremely angry, and I get so hot every time. You see, I'm having a match with Jimmy Valiant. I know that that Paul Jones, you see what happens? Nobody asked for this person's interference. Nobody wanted this person's interference. I'd just like to handle things in my own way, absolutely my own way. And this ignorant peasant comes leaping in the ring. You see the way he's carrying on there? The way he's carrying on there now with his walking stick. Not even any pretense at all. At wrestling. You see him crawling around the ring. I'd like to smash this guy's brains right out of his head. He's leaping. That's good. Jimmy Valiant's punching him. I'm kicking him. I'd like to pull this guy's head right off his shoulders. I'd like to handle things in my own way. I don't need...
What's the assassin any, in there?
Yes. I don't need any interference from him, the assassin, or anybody else. I'd like to handle things in my own way.
Adrian, you and the assassin, you and everybody were going at it in there. It looked like a wild melee.
He is so obsessed with getting at James Valiant, he just doesn't care who he steps on while he's there.
Who's the big man there?
I hate being interrupted when I'm talking, and I hate even more being interrupted when I'm fighting. Look at the way he's carrying on. He's there, he comes with his cane, pushing, poking his nose into other people's business. Well, there's no way I would stand that from him. From anybody else, but especially from him. You know,
I gotta ask you about Kamala in there, even if I have to interrupt you. What about the big black man?
What about the big black man? He is controlled. He is controlled by this Paul Jones, who comes poking his nose into other people's business.
Look what he just did.
Yes. He doesn't care. That's exactly what I said. He doesn't care who he steps on, who he pushes, just to have his own way. Look, he's even hitting a referee. There is no way he'd do that if he was in the ring on his own. I'd like to have that man in the ring. I'd like to have him in the ring.
And he had that cane, and he was slugging and punching with a cane.
Yeah, how brave is he when he hasn't got a cane, when he hasn't got an assassin, and when he hasn't got a Kamala behind him? He's a big shot now, isn't he? See the way he's carrying on? Look at him. He's like a conductor conducting an orchestra with his buffoons. With his buffoons he's got sort of rolling around all over the place.
And Kamala again is beating you up. Beating you up there, Kamala.
I didn't even see what was beating me up. Up there, something hit me, everything was black. I just didn't know what day of the week it was.
And both of them.
And Jimmy Valiant, I've got to say, he's a lot more man than I ever give him credit for before. I've always respected him. He's a very tough guy, a very hard wrestler. A really rough man to handle. He turned out to be a gentleman after all, not like that pig.
It looks like you're out at this point, and Miss Linda's having to go over and administer to you.
Yeah, and the way Miss Linda was manhandled by Paul Jones is a wonder she was fit enough to administer to anybody. Just look at this, it's disgraceful. There's two men having a fight. I've had my differences with Jimmy Valiant. He's had his differences with me. We were in there fighting, just doing what we were supposed to do. And then we get that idiot. Oh, talking hey, about idiot.
Hi, Bob. Hi, girls. Let me tell you something. The only reason, Tutti Frutti, that I come down because you wasn't man enough to beat Jimmy Valiant. Jimmy Valiant ought to be ashamed of himself for wrestling you. And if you don't watch it, you're going to be on the registry.
You don't vacate yourself from these premises at once. And I mean at once, Paul Jones. I'll set Miss Linda on you.
Get out.
I don't need it.
Paul, of course, grabbed her by the hair and slammed her down. And here's Kamala again as Street is flat down on the floor. Kamala, here's Jones with a cane. Miss Linda being held off by the assassin as Jones continues to drive the cane now into Street. And here comes Jimmy Valiant. And here comes...
Let's take time out for these commercial messages about the worldwide wrestling events coming up in your area.
The Greensboro Coliseum is the place to be Saturday, July 7th. On that card, you'll see the Giant Kamala, plus in tag team action. Assassins 1-2 against the Midnight Express. The NWA television title, Ricky Steamboat takes on Tully Blanchard. Then, Paul Jones has to get in the ring with the exotic Adrian Street and Miss Linda for 5 minutes. Then a match for the world's heavyweight title. Ric Flair, the champion, is up against Chief Wahoo McDaniels. Wahoo, that's going to be some match.
Well, you know, Flair, you told me go out and become the number one challenger and you would wrestle me. Well, you know, we've done a lot of things together we can talk about and a lot of things we can't talk about. but that's all water under the bridge now. I am the U.S. heavyweight champion. How I got it doesn't matter. But I am the number one contender, and when you come to Greensboro, brother, you're going to have to fight the toughest man you ever met in your career.
All right, then exciting wrestling in Harrisonburg, the Harrisonburg High School Gym. That's on Thursday, July 12th. Then wrestling is coming to Lynchburg, the Lynchburg Armory. That's on Friday, July 13th. On that card, you'll see Nikita Koloff. Then a match for the NWA World Tag Team title. Ivan Koloff and Don Knuddle, they're up against Mark Youngblood and the Renegade. First, Mark, this is going to be a tough match.
Well, you know what? Don and Ivan, you guys have been going around saying that you left us in the ring. But that's wrong. You did something to us that you hurt us really bad. But I tell you what, we're not going to stop for anything. We're not going to stop for bloodshed. We're not going to stop for war. I guarantee you, you guys made a mistake by jumping in the ring with the Youngblood and Renegade. So I guarantee you, you're going to have a battle on your hands. Koloff, Knuddle, I want you to take a good look at the man that you put in the hospital for 3 weeks. I had to stay out on the desert for 7 days and seven nights and get my thoughts back together and my roots. Knuddle, Koloff, you are the one that made the Renegade. You are the one that made this monster. Everybody has seen what the Renegade and Mark Youngblood has done to you on nationwide television. We beat the living tar out of you. Well, we're coming here to Lynchburg, brother, on the 13th of July. And it is not going to stop for 1 second. Because what you did to me not only hurt my brother right here, but it hurt the Renegade, and I'm coming, and I'm not going to quit until it's all over.
Tag team action! And you see what a mass of muscle Nikita Koloff is. That's right, it's the nephew of Ivan Koloff in there. Also, Don Knuddle, Ivan Koloff and Don Knuddle, the World Tag Team Champions, and Nikita Koloff. Boy, is he big. Against Michael Samuel Houston, who's in the ring right now, Bret Hart and Mark Fleming. Into that turnbuckle, hard! Sam Houston, he is fired up. Everybody's fired up. Listen to him. In the back, takes Houston, whips him into the ropes, catching him with the elbow down on that mat. I'm anxious to see Nikita Koloff fight in now again. Backdrop, hard down on the small of the back. Makes that tag to Nikita. And Nikita comes in, shout, proud. You can see, throws Houston out. Stands over him like a giant. Takes Houston, turns it around, whips him into the ropes, catches him. That elbow takes his time, comes over, makes that tag to Knuddle. Ooh, what a man he is. Snapmare by Knuddle. And Nikita picks him up, slams Bret Hart down the mat, drops that knee across the chest, whips Bret into the ropes, catches him, an elbow right in that midsection, knocks the wind out, picks him up again, backbreaker. Remember, some people that want the World Tag Team Champions, the Freebirds, they're coming to Worldwide Wrestling. Plus, The Road Warriors have issued a challenge to the world. Then you, the Renegade and Mark Youngblood, they want the World Tag Team Champions. But now there's another man outside that ring. You see, Bret Hart fighting back. Fight, goes. Almost, almost. Knuddle takes it, catching it right in the ropes. As he says, he's the pride of the Carolinas. Rams him into the foot. Of Koloff, all right, Snapmare. He tags Nikita. Nikita walks in. Look at him! Mass! On this man. Huge! Listen to fans yelling at Nikita. Tags, Koloff, Koloff. What a mess that Nikita is. Red rims out of the way, good, makes the tag. Lamar Fleming, Fleming comes in, and four more. Whips Koloff into the rope, backdrop. Come on, Mark. Koloff catches him. Throws him into the rope, catches that neck. Picks him. Into the rope. Oh, catches that neck again. Koloff runs across. Dives. The knee in the back. Right, look at it. They're discussing how they want to torture this young man. Snapmare. Diving fist. Into Mark Fleming. Pinodal now. Oh, four! And Houston knocks him out the ring. Snapmare. You see Houston try to come in. Diving fist again. Into Mark Fleming. This threesome of Pinodal, Koloff, and Nikita. Devastating. What a three. The Freebirds are coming. The Road Warriors are coming. Mark, Youngblood, and the Renegade are here. But this team of Koloff and Cornodal, World Tag Team Champions. There's something. You see Koloff right now. He's counting away. Houston. Trying to get Mark Fleming to make that tag. You see, across the chest. Koloff now. Takes Fleming. Poor man. He's having problems standing up. Koloff pounding away at his back. Comes across again. Dives into the back. Amar Fleming tags Don Knoedel. This what? The second rope. Fleming down on that mat. Nikita. The massive. Nikita has him up. Hard slam on that mat. Look at him. Standing over, growling at him. Picks him up again. Prances around proudly. Slams him hard down on the mat. Tries to throw him through the mat. Akita now takes Fleming again. Throws him into the ropes. Catches him in that bear hug. Like a vice. Like a vice. It has Mark Fleming. There you see, Cornotto coming off that second rope. Drop kicks right in the face. Mark Fleming, your winners, Koloff, Cornotto, and Nikita. With me right now, Paul Jones and the Assassin, and we saw your animal Kamala.
Listen, David, we're out here right now to make it official that Adrian Street is now on the registry. So Adrian Street, if you're listening, you better either pack your bags or stand up for the beating that you're going to receive. Since we had the registry, nobody took it serious. But since I put the great Assassin and Kamala together, everybody's scared.
All right, I talked about the threesome. Don Cornotto, Ivan Koloff, the world
tag team. That's right. Let's cut the small talk. Cut the small talk. As you just saw, you saw the greatest addition in wrestling today. You saw Nikita Koloff, nephew of Ivan Koloff, Olympic weightlifter, Olympic wrestler, Olympic track and field man. He's going to be a world champion. Now about the Renegade, and we've been hearing you run your mouth out here, brother. And don't you think that the hospital don't take Renegades, because they do, right? I would tell them about it.
We're going to get rid of this Renegade like we just started to do. We're going to finish it and any other team.
This is the next week on the best in wrestling, worldwide wrestling. What a devastating team this is.
Worldwide Wrestling.